Hello students, I am Asmatullah from JK Jain School. Today we are going to continue our fifth chapter of 11th standard, that is market structure and pricing. In our previous class, we have learned about the perfect competition, right? And we saw the various aspects with related to the perfect competition, like short run, long run curve, and we have discussed the normal profit, abnormal profit and loss. In today's class, we'll take the first thing of imperfect market. In our previous class, we have learned the what is perfect market and what is imperfect market, right? What is perfect market? When many variables are fixed, like price, market, demand, supply are fixed, what happens? That is what we call perfect market. And the imperfect market or imperfect competition are those conditions where there is no fixation of price or all the other things. Okay? On the imperfect competition, the first thing is monopoly. The first part is monopoly. What is monopoly? It is a condition, or it is a place, or it is something that one buyer, one seller, one rule. This has been right from the combination of Greek words. It has been right from the Greek word monopoly. Mono means single, polo means seller. Single seller. Where there is only single seller in the market, that market is known as monopoly market. A market situation in which there is only one seller of a commodity, so there is no scope for competition. You are the single person to hold the entire market. No one is selling the same thing that you are selling. That is what we call single seller. Very important word as far as the monopoly is concerned. Monopoly means single seller. There is only one seller, single seller. He decides everything. Price, output, input, everything he decides. That's what the meaning says. A market situation in which there is only one seller of a commodity. So, when there is only one person who is selling a commodity, there will be no competition. You are going for a shop and you are purchasing a fruits like apple. What happened? The seller will sell you the 20 rupees. 1 kg, 20 rupees. You can go to the next shop, he will say for 18 rupees. Next of 22 rupees, 25 rupees, 10 rupees. So there is many sellers of apple, there is a competition. But you are going to the Indian Railways. Going to the Indian Railways. They say that from Tamil Nadu to Gujarat, Tamil Nadu to Gujarat, the fare is for second class 800 means you don't have any other option to go to somewhere else. You will not go to the Australian railway market or US market or China market. You will book another train and go. You have just one market. Indian Railway you have to adopt and you have to pay it. This is the best example. Indian Railway is the best example for monopoly market. Okay? Let's see some of the features of monopoly market. There is a single producer, seller of a product. There is only one producer, only one seller of a product. There can be not two or three, only one. He is manufacturer, he is the seller, that's all. The product is with him, everything, all the rights and duties is with him. He will fix the price, he will fix the market, he will fix the buyer, he will fix everything. If he wants to sell, he will sell. Simple. He is the solo owner. He is the decider. No one can interfere. Point number two. Product is unique. And the second condition is the product will be unique. It will be different from other product. How? Indian Railway has been taken as an example. Right? Indian Railway is unique. Come back to the other transport. So,
when the monopolistic market is there, the first condition should be there should be only one owner. Who is the owner of Indian Railway? Indian government, this central government. Whether the product is unique? Yes, it's a unique service. Point number three, strict barriers for entry of new firms. Strict barriers. Barriers means problems. Strict. They cannot be entered into new firm. Ambani has a lot of money. He is the richest man in India. He says, I will have my own railways to run in India. Not possible. Adani says that he will run his own railway in India. Not possible. Bill Gates says that he will have his own railways in India. Not possible. Because the entry of a new firm, the entry of a new business, the entry of a new seller, the entry of a new player is limited. It's nil. It's almost impossible. No one can do it. Like a defense. If someone says they have a lot of money like Bill Gates or Mark Zuckerberg, Mark of Facebook, offers Facebook or the Sundar Pichai, he says that he will run a defense or he will run a defense. Useless thing, because the entry is not locked. Monopolistic market, there is strict rules that there will be a no entry of a new player, new businessman or new one, anyone. Whoever is their own, he will continue. Monopolistic is a price maker. And monopolistic market has the best return. The return is price maker. You are a businessman, you don't have a right, you does not have a right to fix a price. I am a businessman of a pen, but I don't have a right to fix the rate of the pen. Who is the manufacturer who will fix it? Although I am the wholesaler or a retailer of a shop, I am not the maker of the price. But the monopolistic persons, the monopolistic seller are the one who decides the price. Who is the maker of the price? Because it is product. No one has the control over it. Last point. On maximum profit and abnormal profit. And in the monopolistic market, in the monopoly market, there is a maximum earning of profit. There is a maximum earning of profit. So, five things. Single producer should be there. Product should be unique. No new entry. Price maker. And maximum profit. Five things. Let's see some of the sources of monopolist power. So what is the sources of monopoly power? Source number one, natural monopoly. Natural monopoly are those monopoly
which tells you the various aspect or various attributes with regards to
natural monopolies. It's those kind of aspects that teaches you the various. You have something from the nature. You are not the creator of that. If I am having a bag industry, I am producing a bag, I am manufacturing a bag, but that will not come under nature. Something that has been given by the Almighty, that is, has been given by the nature, like a river, like a trees, like an air, all these kind of things. So, gold and coal. Gold, you know, gold or diamonds. Where we find it? We find inside the land. Someone has created that. The Almighty has created. The nature gives. The gold or a coal. You can find inside the earth. Inside the soil you can find out these things. So natural monopoly are those. If I am the person and I am living in Chennai and I have a land. In that land, suddenly I have got the 5 kilos of gold. That is my monopoly. I have that gold. I will fix the price of that. That is my thing. Coal. Like that. So that is a gift given to a person
or receives a person.